Hello, and welcome to the Schooner Simulation. I'm your host, Michael Whitman, and today's episode is sponsored by DraftKings. Sign up with the promo code TPPN to get started at the link in the description. We've got an exciting edition of The Sim today, as we have a new game to run the simulation on. Legend Bowl from Super Pixel Games is a brand new arcade-style football game that is reminiscent of Tecmo Bowl, but with better AI and much more customization. The base game utilizes original teams so as not to infringe on copyright. However, the Discord surrounding the game has an active community that's produced this NCAA skin mod, an NFL mod, and rosters for both. While not a perfect representation, the updated rosters for this game are supposed to be fairly accurate to the updated rosters from the Operation Sports Forum. The Sooners come out strong on offense with a massive sprint by Eric Gray to go for the first score of the game. Wasting no time getting back into it, Deuce responds with a massive touchdown run of his own, but their kicker simply doesn't have the leg to kick the extra point, or the kickoff, effectively. Both teams end up finding it difficult to get into the end zone, and with kicking being severely nerfed, neither side really has the opportunity to put points on the board until another breakout from KSU. We can't really blame the offense or defense for this, as both seem to be responsible for different issues on their sides. Yeah, this is definitely an arcade game more than it is a sim. Fun to play, not so much accurate to the players. This game ends 7-13 in the Wildcats' favor, and the only analysis I can give is if you want to play a great football game and support a small developer, give this title a look. A link to the game's website will be in the description below. I think we'll have a little bit more luck and a more accurate sim in the realm of 3D.
Nope.
This week, Oklahoma travels to Manhattan, Kansas to play against the Wildcats. If you're new here, we'll be setting these two teams against each other, setting the AI to the highest difficulty, and analyzing the gameplay footage. The updated rosters, courtesy of the Operation Sports Forum, are used to ensure we have the right players, and the College Football Revamped modification is used to update visuals. Check out links to both in the description below. While the last game wasn't exactly as routine as I had thought it would be, I don't see K-State bringing out any flashy alternate uniforms, so I'm sticking them in their Wildcat purple jerseys while OU reps their whites. The first away game for the season brings a unique set of challenges this unit hasn't seen yet, not the least of which being a 2:30 kickoff time. Dark Sky is currently predicting a very cloudy 72 degrees with a 10-mile-an-hour wind, giving us a taste of what the mythical fourth season of fall might feel like. The Sooners start with the ball, and their back and forth with the defense is kinda hard to watch. Steady progression up the field with Brooks, a jet sweep from Woods, and a pass or two to Hazelwood keep pushing the ball forward, but just as many mistakes on the O-line and bad decisions from Rattler keep pushing them back. Not to mention that on the first drive, Woods ends up going down, taking out one of our key players on our already waning wideout depth chart. The Sooners are stopped within field goal range and are forced to kick, which Berkich masterfully makes to draw first blood. Aw, look how happy Boomer is. I used to be that happy. Then this game happened. Take what I've said for the previous drive, rinse and repeat. Then start taking out the part where the offense drives down the field. That's basically how the rest of the game went. As a matter of fact, just know that all the plays you've seen so far are the biggest runs and throws that happened the entire game. Nothing the offense seemed to do could slip through the Wildcat defense, and I'm not entirely sure it was because they're that good either. The most notable part of the game actually happened at the end, as the offense finally rallied to push down the field to hopefully score before time runs out to win the game. And when they finally reach the red zone, Rattler gets injured. To all of you who wanted to see Caleb in the game last week, he couldn't get the job done either. You happy? I know I kind of spoiled it, but if I'm being honest, the defense didn't look too bad. They just couldn't quite bail out an offense that couldn't find the end zone the entire game, and they shouldn't have to. The D-line shut down Deuce Vaughn the whole first half, and where there might have been holes, Nick Benito quickly patched them up. But the focus on the run game caused them to absolutely get burned in the secondary, with wide-open passes that helped Will Howard, and yes, I checked, Skylar Thompson is still out, find Malik Knowles for a Wildcat touchdown. Howard did give up a garbage-time fumble right before the end of the half, marking the only turnover for the Sooner defense. After the break, Vaughn decided to play receiver over runner, forcing the defense to adapt, and they did the best they could, but still couldn't stop the Wildcats from pulling ahead with a touchdown pass to Phillip Brooks and a field goal to top it off. They would go on to hold this lead for the rest of the game until the clock expires. Wildcats prevail 13-9. Before you ask in the comments, yes, those scores from before this segment were the results of me simulating the game under the exact same conditions, mostly in denial, and aside from a miracle here or there, the results were dreadfully the same. There was one ray of hope, though, and that came when I was doing some testing and simmed the game on a sunny day. Not only did the Sooners win, but absolutely dominated Kansas State, winning by about 20 points, if my memory serves me correctly. So, final thoughts. Everyone should either practice their best anti-rain dance or prepare to have a horrible time this Saturday. Do you think the sim will be accurate this go-round? Leave your score predictions in the comments below. Then, check out the weekend spread to hear Bobby, Ty, Jameson, and Blake give you their predictions for all of this week's matchups.